Okay, so in the last session we talked about the primary key and we created, for example, a customer number or employee number or role number. Okay, and it is always unique and it does not, it should not have the empty values or the it should not have the null values. Okay, and I told you what you mean by the null keyword. Okay, so null is not supposed to be given in the single quote. Null has to be given as it is. Okay, without single quote, without double quote. Please understand it properly because it is not a name. Okay, it is a term, or we can say it's a keyword which is used in SQL. Okay, fine. So now we are going to talk about the foreign key. So this is the customer number which we have created as a primary key, and here we are having a foreign key. So we will try to create a table, one more table containing, say, assuming one employee may have many jobs. Here how we had one customer may have many orders. In the same manner, I want to write it down. An employee who is doing many jobs. Okay, so how he is doing many jobs? Maybe in the morning he is working at some departmental store, in the evening he is working at some garage or something like that. Okay, or he is going to give a delivery. So in this manner it would be something like too many jobs. If suppose one person is doing, so I am going to make a relationship from one employee to many jobs. Okay, so here let's see what all tables we have. So select star from tab. Whenever I give, here I have EMP table, so I can see DESC EMP. fine. Now I want to create a table job, so I am going to create table job. Okay, and then I'm going to write down, please keep it in mind, all we have to create its attributes first of that particular entity. So job ID, so I'm saying say number 3, or you can give number 4, whatever you want to give. Okay, job profile, or we can say the type. Okay, so I want to give job profile. It can be a painter or carpenter or maybe a delivery person or something like that. So here I'm going to give here varchar. Please keep it in mind, whenever I give varchar, though I'm giving varchar here, it is taking it as varchar 2. It understands, SQL understands it as varchar 2, whether you are talking about Oracle 10G or 11G or 12C. Okay, so here I'm giving here say 15. Okay, please keep it in mind, I want to keep the primary key to foreign key. So here you can see the primary key is over here. Okay, here its own primary key, but it will have the foreign key from here to here. Okay, so I'll have to create one more column. Fine, what is that? Employee number. Now please keep it in mind, you might be having question that here I have created ENO, here I'll be creating EMPNO. It is not going to make any difference because finally this ENO would be connected to this EMPNO. So I'm going to write it down here, the same data type and the size, okay, as this one. Here I have given 2, here I will give more than 2 or 2. Okay, here I have given 2 or more than 2 or 2, and then I'm going to write it down foreign key, foreign, foreign key. EMPNO references, which table? EMP. What is it doing? It is creating a foreign key on EMPNO, this EMPNO, which is referencing to this EMP table, and it has got column as ENO. And this bracket is for this one and this bracket is for the first one. So let's see whether it works or not. Yes, it worked. Okay, so in this manner I created the foreign key and I gave here DESC. Now what is my table name? Job. Can you see here? Job ID, job profile, and then EMPNO number 2. Fine, I forgot to give a primary key to job ID. Obviously, each entity, each table will have its own primary key. I can do alter. Okay, so alter table job, add primary key to job ID. Okay, I can, yes. Now let's see what is there. Yeah, it's not null, that is primary key. This will be foreign key, is not shown as such. In MySQL it is shown properly, here it is not shown, but yes, it's a primary key. Now foreign key. Now we'll try to insert the values. So what are the values are there in the your parent table? Always keep it in mind, wherever the primary key is given, it's a parent table, and wherever the foreign key is given, it's a child table. Child table is always connected to the parent table. Okay, so here EMP ENO is 1245. It is the three employee number is not present. Let's see. Try to insert it. Insert into job values. Okay, I'll try to insert here firstly 1. Okay, job ID is 1. Okay, or I'll say 101. Job profile is delivery boy. Okay, and I want to give here the employee number as say 1, because this employee number 1 is a delivery boy having salary as 38,000, birth date is something. Okay, or I can say he is a carpenter. Okay, and here he has the say the employee number is 1. So let's see. Yeah, it's working fine. So if I give here select star from job, fine, it gave me. But now I'll try to insert it in such a way that 102 job ID is 102. Okay, I want to give here say proprietor or say X job. Okay, and if I give here again that value which is not present over here, it is 1245. 3 is not there. I'll try to give here 3, whether it will give me an error. It will give me an error because the thing is this 3 is not present here. Still I'm trying to give. The meaning is the foreign key is always dependent on the primary key, and this is my primary key and this will be my foreign key. But if I give here 4, okay, it would give me now. And if I give here select star from EMP, you can see here this 1 and 4, 4 is doing X job, 1 is doing carpenter's job, having name as M, 4 doesn't have name. Because I was telling you about the not the null value that time, that's why I had not put the name. Okay, and then the salary is 78,000 or 38,000 respectively. Okay, in this manner the foreign key and the primary key work, and they are dependent on this fundamental of RDBMS, that is ER model. Thank you very much. I think that you must have understood. Please give me the feedback. Stay tuned.